seated. Welcome to the McNeil High School 1995 commencement exercises. Commencement means a beginning. Therefore, this graduation not only signifies the completion of one part of one's life, but the beginning of a new one. Graduation is a time to honor seniors, their families, and friends. It is a time for solemn and dignified behavior, and the seniors have requested that their graduation be conducted as such. McNeil High School has achieved the reputation of being a first-class school, and we are very proud of what our students have accomplished. So let us observe this graduation with a dignity that it does deserve. We ask that you do not leave your seats to take pictures, as professional photographers and video photographers will be taking pictures. We also ask that at the end of the ceremony that you remain in your seats until all seniors have recessed. Seniors will leave out the Red River entrance and will go proceed to the flagpoles on the north side of Urban Center. That's where you'll be able to meet them. The presentation of colors will be conducted by the McNeil High School Air Force Junior ROTC under the direction of Lieutenant Colonel Bill Wilson and Chief Fred Zablosky. The pledge will be led by the 1994-95 student class president, Ramya Srinivasan, and the national anthem will be played and sung by the McNeil High School Band and Choir. Now for the presentation of colors.
Go what? Go!
Please stand.
Usher! Forward! Upward! Left!
Please join me in the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
Our thanks this afternoon will be given by Jeff Lee, Senior Class Vice President.
At this time, we would like to give thanks. We, the senior class of McNeil High School, would like to give thanks to many, for we have much to be thankful for. We will not walk across the stage on our own effort, but with the help, support, and love of many. This time in our commencement ceremony, we want to thank the people who have been there for us. The McNeil senior class of 1995 is grateful for the unconditional love, ongoing support, an incredible sacrifice that our parents, teachers, principals, and loved ones have given and continue to give to us. Thanks to our parents who raised us, protected us, showed us right from wrong, and more importantly, loved us, no matter how much we went wrong. Thanks to our teachers who supported us, cared about us, prepared us for some of those moments in life that can't be explained out of a textbook. And thanks to a principal whose love for his work, school, and students is a love that is indescribable, a love that never dies. And for the many others in our lives that have helped us along this great trail, we are thankful. McNeil High School is honored by your presence here this afternoon. By simply being here today, you show us the love and excitement that you share with us during this great occasion. As we journey into the new experiences that await for us, we, the graduating class of McNeil High School, just want to say thanks.
We'd like to take this opportunity to recognize our guest on stage. This is the second year, I believe, that we have organized our district into vertical teams. Vertical team meaning that with McNeil High School, we have two middle schools and several elementary schools. And we work together as a team trying to do what's best for our kids, K through 12. And we've asked today that our feeder school principals or assistant principals be here with us, and I would like to introduce them at this time. From Fernbluff Elementary, if you could hold your applause at the end. From Fernbluff Elementary, Catherine McKenzie, assistant principal. Romel Parker, principal at Forest North Elementary. David Moore, principal, Live Oak Elementary. Annette Johnson, principal, Rushy Creek Elementary. Royce Swain, principal, Pond Springs Elementary. Carolyn Hood, principal, Jollyville Elementary. One that means a lot to you because he helped us open McNeil High School, Mr. Chuck Ament, principal, Wells Branch Elementary. Representing Cedar Valley Middle School, assistant principal, Ms. Selena Russell. And Jeff Rhodes, principal, Deer Park Middle School. Please give them a hand. Representing Central Administration and School Board, if you could hold your applause, Nick Bolts, our Fine Arts Director and Director of Community Relations, and also the person responsible for handling the graduation today here at Irwin Center. Mike Jolly, Chief Financial Officer for the district. Don Howard, Assistant Superintendent for Support Services. Dr. Amanda Batson, Assistant Superintendent for Area 2. Dr. Mary Bull, Assistant Superintendent for Area 1. Dr. Ellen Massey, my boss, assistant superintendent for, of course, the best area, our Area 3. Dr. Terry Bishop, associate superintendent for administration. Dr. Tom Norris, our superintendent. Rigo Bahayo, board member. Archie Holmes, board member. Kathy C., board member. Nelda Click, board member. Our secretary of the Board of Trustees, Raymond Hartfield. Vice President of the Board of Trustees, Stephen Copenhaver, and President of our Board of Trustees, Mr. Oscar Pettis. Please give them a hand. McNeil High School, our stage guest. Two people who have had to really put up with me all this week trying to get this thing together. My immediate boss, Sharon Dillard, my secretary. Sandy Sawicki, our registrar. Amy Land, one of our announcers. Deanna Allen, one of our announcers. Miss Emmy Johnson, diagnostician. Judy Bazarski, diagnostician. Jinx Lacey, our support counselor. Our counselors, Ruby Castile, Janice Walker, Elaine Smith, Sharon Bishop, Joe Gregg, our assistant principals, Mr. T.J. Dilworth, Stephanie Kirshner, Dorothy Shaw, and my associate principal, Daryl Phillips. Please give them a hand. Our special students on stage, Candace Ripperda, our class salutatorian. Jennifer Gatchell, our class valedictorian. Patrick Bogart, student class vice president. Ramya Srinivasan, student council president. Jeff Lee, senior class vice president. Javi Romero, senior class vice president. And your senior class president, Robert Corkill. Please give them a hand. I would also like to acknowledge a few people who are not on duty and are giving up their summer time. First of all, our band directors, Randy Smith, Mark Pewich, Dr. Tom Rainey, and our band. Kay Sherrill, our choir director, and two of our finest choirs. Lieutenant Colonel Bill Wilson and Chief Keys Oblosky. Senior class sponsors, and Kevin Brown, Linda Hinks, Betty Monson, and Molly Rain, and approximately 40 to 45 other faculty members who are here today on their voluntary time. One other person, Don Overall from Herb Jones, who has worked extremely hard with our kids to make sure they get their caps and gowns even to the last minute today. Please give these people a round of applause. At this time, the senior class message will be given by Robert Corkill, Jennifer Gatchell, and Patrick Bogart.
We have reached another day in our lives, high school graduation, but not without creating many unforgettable memories. I'd like to share those memories with you, treasures, if you will, that I have stored in my magical chest. Opening the chest, I remember our early days, searching and finding the leftover pieces in my life that meant the most to me. I've discovered special moments in the past. A beaten-up bicycle I once rode, the many children's books my mom tucked me in with at night, and the melted birthday candles whose enticing flames, like me, enjoyed the celebration of another year. As children, we were developing our personalities and building our values, which would take us onward. Marching on to middle school, we found friendships, were introduced to responsibilities, and learned the meaning of competition, both in athletics and academics. As I look once more into my chest, I find a dirty old football that reminded me of irreplaceable memories. Football allowed me to experience how a group can come together to achieve a common goal. We worked hard, pushed each other to perform beyond our own expectations, and shared in the joy of each other's triumphs. I remember those faces in the huddle, those big boys that are now by my side. I know that the experience of football can be replaced by so many objects that are as important to you, my fellow graduates. Whether looking back at your deflated soccer balls, worn-out dance shoes, scarred baseball bats, a torn-up ticket to a drama production, or a well-deserved medallion for an academic UIL competition, we all can relive our certain moments. We slowly matured, and then came McNeil High School, which allowed us more responsibilities to grow from within and become individuals. If a man does not keep pace with his companions, perhaps it is because he hears a different drummer. Let him step to the music that he hears, however measured or far away. Henry David Thoreau helps us realize and then celebrate our individuality. We accept many challenges and explore down many paths. We come to appreciate our parents, teachers, and principals because they have molded us into what we are today. My parents started that sculpture and carved me into a caring and compassionate young man. Dad, remember when you delivered the eulogy for Grandpa's funeral? That love that poured out of you as you expressed your feelings will always be planted deeply inside my heart. It meant so much to me, and I want to deliver that love to both you and Mom. My teachers and principals welcomed that young man you helped create and encouraged me to grasp opportunities, giving me a sense of direction for my goals. I owe all of you a heartfelt thank you for your dedication, and I would like to place that thank you into my treasure chest. One looks back with appreciation at the brilliant teachers, but with gratitude to those who touched our human feelings. The curriculum is so much necessary raw material, but warmth is the element for the growing soul of a child. You have touched my soul and have challenged me to find my special voice, and I have. As I begin to close my treasure chest of memories, I would like to say a fond farewell to the past, making sure that I will never forget what challenging, triumphant memories that you, my principals, my teachers, my friends, and my family have given me.
In the words of John Wayne, tomorrow is the most important thing in life. It comes to us at midnight, very clean. It is perfect when it arrives and it places itself in our hands. It hopes we have learned something from yesterday. On this day of commencement, as we, the class of 1995, prepare to meet the challenges of tomorrow, the view ahead appears both exhilarating and intimidating. At one moment, we move towards tomorrow with excitement, making plans for our college days and our careers, plans that will transform our dreams into reality. At the next moment, however, we cannot help but pause and glance back over our shoulders at all the special experiences, places, and people that we must leave behind. Today, we face a key point of transition in our lives, one like no other we have ever faced before, nor will again. For although we fondly remember who we were, and we have confidence in who we are, we can only anticipate all that we will become. As we sit here today with stomachs churning and high hopes soaring, a chapter in each of our lives ends. We say goodbye to locker combinations, to pep rallies, and to homecoming football games. We bid farewell to the security of high school, to teachers who have instilled in us both facts and wisdom, and to friendships that have shaped our lives and our hearts. Yet even as this chapter closes, the memory of yesterday lives inside of us, and the lessons that we have learned will forever guide us. One of my teachers once said, "Flowers die, children cry. New days, new ways, love stays." Today, with these warm memories in our hearts, a chapter begins. We look forward to exploring new opportunities. We look forward to the brilliant future we see ahead of us. We look forward to the challenges we will face, standing strong and feeling free. Tomorrow always beckons. Most of all, we look forward to its promise, which can inspire new efforts to achieve, to grow, and to aim forever higher. Today, as we step forward to receive our diplomas, we embark upon a journey. 1,000 pathways will open for us, but which path to choose, how to decide? Are you good enough, they'll ask you? Are you smart enough, they'll question? At no other time in our lives will we be faced with such freedom to choose and to create our destiny. We must use what we have learned and look within our hearts to find and to follow the path that is uniquely our own. If we continue aiming towards our goals, success will be ours. Our journey will be one of endless discovery. Discovery of the world, discovery of what is possible, and discovery of ourselves. Today marks the crossroads in our lives, the end of one era, and the beginning of another. However, today is also a time of celebration and pride. For 4 years, we have worked continuously and have pushed ourselves to reach reached this day. And now that we have finally arrived, let us bask in the pride all around us. Believe every single word of praise that we hear. Cherish our friendships. Sing the McNeil School song. Join hands with those around us and remember who they are. Thank a teacher. Kiss our parents. Twirl our tassels. Hug Mr. Veach. Spend time saying goodbyes. Cry a little. Smile a lot. Take thousands of pictures. Read every word of our diplomas. Make promises to keep in touch. Feel unique. Celebrate ourselves. On this day of commencement, believe in all that you have accomplished. Believe in your future. And most of all, believe in yourself. We are all winners, and nothing can stand in our way.
Way back on August 16th, the first day of our senior year, I bought myself a calendar, quickly turned to the month of May, and circled, highlighted, drew huge stars, did everything short of hanging neon lights on the day, May 26th, graduation day. Incredibly, the meter that once read 284 days until graduation has now dwindled down to a few scant moments. I think many of you will agree that even though we've looked to this day with great anticipation, those 284 days, filled with great memories, the homecoming football game victory, a dedicated hall monitor dubbed H.E.B. Man, an English teacher Molly Rain dancing down at prom 95, have flown by surprisingly quickly, leaving many of us struggling to keep pace with the changes that will soon occur and simultaneously wondering where our senior year went. And as we take this time to reflect on the ride that we will soon depart, we also attempt to create an image of what the future will look like. Filled with excitement and tempered by uncertainty, our imaginations run wild with the possibilities that are now in our grasp. I've often found myself attempting to draw an image of the next time that we come together as Mavericks, perhaps at our 20th high school reunion in the year 2015. I've often thought about what that scene will look like, the careers that will be entered, the accomplishments made, the marriages, the children, where we meet again, when we meet again, we will undoubtedly be a little grayer, somewhat wider, and tragically, undeniably balder. But let there be little doubt that whatever uncertainty the future holds, the successes of the future belong to us. Great success is always preceded by great preparation, and for the last 3 years, we've undergone that great preparation. It is now up to us to take the blessings we have been provided and turn them into success. Each one of us has the knowledge and the talent to contribute to the promise of a beautiful future. Each one of us has the potential to rank among the best in our chosen fields. Each one of us has the ability to succeed, to help, and to make a difference. At no other time have there been so few impediments to our dreams. Sure, we face problems, but none so large enough that we cannot solve. All across the world, people are looking to us and people like us to make use of the great preparation that our parents and this school has provided us. In this gallery of hope that we illuminate, people look at their problems and look at us as solutions. Unfortunately, what may be lacking in some is the self-confidence to realize that the abilities you now possess give you the opportunity to accomplish anything you dare to dream. Today, make a resolution that you will always have confidence in yourself. Never doubt your ability to accomplish, to make life better for those around you, and to be happy. Never doubt that your talents and spirit can change a person's life. While you begin chasing your dreams and goals, remember that getting what you go after is called success, but liking it while you're getting it is called happiness. While accolades and praise have their roles in life, I have recently learned that it does not always take victory to be happy. Some very special people have taught me that it takes friends, relationships, and an understanding and respect for the people around you.
Treasure the opportunity to make new friends and experience new things. Embrace the diversity of people as a chance to experience a diversity of fulfilling emotions that will lead to the happiness of your future. Self-confidence, pride in your talents and abilities, and a respect for all people, thoughts, and ideas. If you can instill those ideas in your mind, heart, and soul, there is not a dream that you cannot accomplish. Eleanor Roosevelt once said that the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. The future belongs to the seniors of the McNeil class of 1995.
Special musical selection today will be presented by the McNeil Varsity and Chamber Women Choirs, both recent sweepstakes winners at the recent UIL competition. Their selection is titled Of Love, lyrics by Robert Fulton, and music by Dee Dee. The pride you have in our kids at McNeil. Three years ago, we were given a chance to mold a new school with our own philosophies about education. We met with many of you students who came from established high schools in the district, and together we decided what path McNeil would take. We decided that McNeil would not be a traditional school, but rather a place where students and teachers would not only have the latitude to try creative innovations, but also be encouraged to do so. We wanted a school with high expectations, and a place where students wanted to do their best. By empowering you, the students, to make decisions about McNeil, you quickly developed a deep love for McNeil High School, and you have nurtured a love for each other, and you have fostered a respect for the talents and gifts of each other. You've come together as one. Most of you were here when McNeil High opened 3 years ago. You helped start many of the traditions that we have. You have established an attitude about learning that serves as a tradition. You see teachers and staff as mentors from whom you seek knowledge, insight, and advice. You have opened up yourselves to the positive influence of schooling and education. You have been willing to take risks, and you don't fear failure. You are largely responsible for making this high school a great place to be, a place with high expectations and a wealth of pride. Our success is well documented. You have garnered many awards and accomplishments over the past 3 years, and especially this year in academics, fine arts, and athletics. You have put McNeil High School on the map in the state of Texas. And to receive over $1 million in scholarship offers is quite an accomplishment for a third-year high school. You are a very talented group in every area. You have been an outstanding group of seniors to work with. We'll miss you. You are the reason McNeil is what it is today. But there's one thing that I hope we have taught you at McNeil, and that is to be a maverick. One who kind of steers away from the herd and becomes independent. You need to be innovative, creative, be a leader, be a thinker. Do what is best for you and what is best for society. Don't always take no as an answer, always ask why. Be able to give your opinion. It is okay to be biased and have an opinion as long as you understand both sides of a problem or of an issue. We have tried to teach you to be independent, and I think that is why you have accomplished so much, and I think that is why you have been so respected by the faculty in this community, and why we respect you so much. You are an incredible, incredible group of students, and you're the reason that I come here every day to work. Love each and every one of you. Dr. Norris, Mr. Pettis, members of the Board of Trustees, it is my privilege to certify that the class of 1995 has fulfilled the requirements set forth by the Texas Education Agency and the Round Rock Independent School District, and therefore these seniors are eligible to receive their diploma. At this time, Mrs. Land and Mrs. Allen will come forth.
Valedictorian Jennifer Gatchell. The salutatorian is Candace Marie Ripperda. Shelly Ann Adamick.
Clayton Christopher Langham.
Carrie O. Adidas.
Sonia Beth Larson.
Brian Philip Allen.
James Wesley Lavender.
Leslie K. Allen.
Chris. Crystal Ann Lee.
Dirk Allen Amon.
Jacqueline Diane Ray Lee.
Kimberly Lynn Andrews.
Jessica Ann Laracas.
Timothy Baker.
Philip Andrew Lindner.
Lee Ballard.
Joey Litz.
Grant Allen Banta.
Gloria Lowe.
Adrian Barker.
Jeffrey Andrew Lee.
Glennis LaShun Barnum.
Javier Lopez Alarcón.
Hilton Barrett.
Kimberly Ray Lucky.
Rachel Renee Barrett.
Crystal Renee Macon.
Sadie Salima Bars.
Katrina Marie Maddens.
Alicia Kaylin Batson.
Christina Marie Madsen.
Alisa Baxter.
Mark Kenji Mancella.
Jeannie Beard.
Eric Damian Marquette. Angel Ann Martin.
Juan Centre Beavers.
Amanda Lynn Martin.
Gabriel Lee Bell.
Stephanie Nicole Mascari.
Shannon Marie Bybee.
Bruce A. Massey.
Eric Biesemeyer.
Chad Maxwell.
Patrick Daniel Bogart.
Diana Elizabeth McDaniels.
Jason William Booth.
Jonathan Gabriel McGee.
Jennifer Lynn Brewer.
Sarah Catherine McKinney.
Brandy Lee Brown.
Nathan Jean McRae.
Lester Wade Brown.
Trenton Lee McRae.
Michelle Renee Bruging.
Leanne Marie McShannon.
Jessica Lee Buckmaster.
Bonita and Marie Medina.
Yeah, Medina!
Ryan D. Bergener.
Allison Lee Menser.
Tamara Lee Burke.
Lisa Ann Miller.
Julie Rhiannon Byfield.
Dwayne Scott Milligan.
Danny R. Caldwell.
Ramsey Montigny.
Joseph Vicente Canet. Canet, excuse me.
Haley Marie Morris.
Didia Elba Cantu.
Kristen Amanda Morris.
Pablo Esteban Cardenas.
Jennifer Morse.
James Grant Carpenter.
Andrea Eddie Mosley.
Jana Delaine Carpenter.
Micah Franz Mosher.
Jennifer Diane Carpenter.
Thomas Paul Myers.
Joshua Allen Carpenter.
Matthew Armand Nash.
Oh, Matthew.
Veronica Marie Castro.
John David Miller Nava.
Joshua Bertrand Kaysen.
Mevetti Wen.
Amanda Jane Chapman.
Christina Nickel.
Jeremy Shane Chapman.
Rochelle Ann Nielsen.
Todd Russell Chipman.
Lindsay Ward Nadlick.
Leslie Ty Chisholm.
Stephen David Norris.
Jonathan Tai Chi Chor.
Thomas Dustin O'Brien.
Peter Daniel Christensen.
Christy Ann Olson.
Erica Mozzie Crouch.
Mozzie!
Chin Ong.
Melissa Renee Clark.
Phyllis O'Quinn.
Zachary D. Clark.
Bradley Darrell Pack.
Annie Lori Clausen.
James David Paul.
Amy Clifford.
Michelle Pearson.
Robert Richard Corkill.
Stephanie K. Perkins.
Garrett Wade Courtney.
Patrick Peters.
Jessica Rashawn Coy.
Fontaine Van.
James Allen Kraft.
Michael Gregory Phillips.
Abby Nicole Cream.
Tori R. Prim.
Stephen Lee Crow.
Jennifer Lynn Prokaski.
Patricia Lynn Crowhurst.
Desiree Danielle Pugh.
Kevin Horace Cruiser.
Melissa Lee Ragland.
Jennifer Cup.
Myla Racevich.
James R. Daniels.
Charles Randolph.
Jacqueline Nicole Davenport.
Kevin T. Rampt.
Ryan A. Davino.
Susan Elizabeth Reed.
Brittany Jennifer Davis.
Andrea Miki Reese.
Leah Davis.
Ellen Meredith Rhodes.
Jennifer Michelle Dawson.
Kelly Christine Reber.
Nathan Joel Deckinga.
Susan Renee Rodenberg.
Ricardo Casares de la Garza.
Timothy James Warren.
Rhonda Dematampitia.
Jeremy Scott Rogers.
Amber Denning.
Eduardo Javier Romero.
Erin Marie Dubb.
Erica Rosales.
Chen Du.
Megan Elizabeth Rao.
Catherine Rose Dunaway.
Matthew James Sage.
Angela Christine Eccles.
Yvette Marie Salinas.
Daniel T. Edison.
Eric Wayne Samuelson.
Andre Lamont Edmondson.
Dominic D. Sanchez.
Amy Elizabeth Ehrenfeld.
Chad Warren Sanders.
Jennifer Deanna Eichenhorst.
Michael Brian Schmidt.
Pamela Ann Erickson.
Jeremy Jack Scholl.
Yeah. Marcus Walter Earlwine.
Walter!
Summer Elisa Schott.
Maritza Espinosa.
Trinessa Nicole Sinet.
Christina Ann Eustace.
Dana Lynn Seward.
Darcy Pauline Evans.
Kathleen Patrice Shaughnessy.
Christopher David Evans.
Sarah Danielle Shine.
Lori Jean Evans.
Joseph Daniel Shirley.
Cameron L. Ihorn.
Gary K. Shu.
Gregory Allen Eister.
Eric Edward Shrimplin.
Annie Cho Ann Fang.
Jamie Ann Seiler.
Crystal Ferguson.
Patricia Denise Silva.
Michael John Fine.
Miguel Vicente Silvas.
Kelly Suzanne Flanagan.
Carrie Lynn Simmons.
Sarah Marie Fallon.
Yeah. Jacob Wilhelm Simpson.
Jeremy Shannon Corbis.
Philip Anthony Simpson.
Christine Rose Fauché.
Jason Stephen Sibbles.
Misty Michelle Foster.
Kevin Edwin Smith.
Kevin Frierson.
Matthew Gregory Smith.
Stephanie Lynn Fritz.
Seneca Justice Smith.
Christopher Randall Frizzell.
Sarah Blythe Sniffen.
Wade Travis Funk.
Daniel Edward Solis.
Lily Galindo.
Craig Lindsay Sosna.
William Chad Gardner.
Clifford Sterling Spratlin.
Christopher Kent Guerin.
Ramya Srinivasan.
Nathaniel Duncan Guerin.
Helen Frances Stewart.
Dominique Michelle John Julio.
Lindsay Lee Stewart.
Joseph Geifer.
Morgan Weeks Stinson.
Cynthia Marie Gillen.
Nebosha Stojanovic.
Jenna Lind Gillen.
Matthew Christian Stotts.
Taryn R. Glass.
Michael Gideon Strait. Kelly Jo Searles.
Edwin Gomez.
Brandy Renee Taylor.
James Gonzalez.
Letitia Renee Taylor. Sean Tegman.
Brian Evans Grant.
Jeff Terrell. Tina Renee Thomas.
Chris M. Green.
Clayton Earl Thompson. David Lewis Thompson.
Andrea Lauren Griffin.
Stephen Michael Thompson.
Griffith.
Ekpeni Manuela Torku.
Stephen Daniel Grisnick.
Christopher Wang Townsend.
Misty Michelle Gurley.
Jessica Ann Townsend.
Julie Ann Haas.
John Onben Tran.
Portia Veronica Hackett.
Brandon Evans Truitt.
Stephanie Annette Hall.
Alana Lee Tomlinson.
Diana Michelle Hamm.
Kevin Vaughn Turner.
Christina Marie Hamill.
Brian Thomas Urbanek.
Laura Jill Hammond.
Christopher Rudy Valles.
Jessica Lee Hardy.
Sarah Ann Van Esty.
Michael Edward Harnish.
Vikram Kaladindi Varma.
Christopher D. Harris.
Sheila Marie Vasquez.
Zach Hathaway.
Kenneth Arthur Vautier.
Christina Marie Heck.
Brian Val Velasquez. Jason Michael Vernon.
James Lee Henderson.
Alan Lane Vickery.
David Edward Pinkin.
Laura Lynn Walker.
Michael Penn.
Timothy Allen Walker.
Brenna Marie Herndon.
Wyoming Maureen Walker.
Kimberly Brooke Higginbotham.
John Wesley Washington.
Benjamin Ryan Hill. Jeffrey Thomas Clayton Hill.
Christopher Eric Whitcomb.
Tim Hodge.
Gregory Christopher White.
William James Holder.
Paul William Whitmer.
Lisa Nicole Holman.
Lawrence E. Williams, Jr.
Kurt Thomas Honingschmidt.
Julie A. Wilson.
Jeremy Jason Hood.
Tion LeBroderick Woods.
Matthew Wayne Houghton.
John James Woodward. Tara Lene Wright.
Jack R. Hudson.
Jamie Ruth Wurz.
Patricia Maria Hudson.
Shan Chang Yi.
Christian Carter Huey.
Jason Dean York.
Justin Ray Hughes.
Amy Michelle Ziegler.
Samuel Augustus Jarman.
Jennifer Denise Zuniga.
Jessica Lynn Jennings.
Brad Lee Swerneman.
Aaron J. Jernigan. Adela Marie Johnson. Jennifer Marie Johnson. Dallas Johnston. Richard Lee Justice Jr. Murdad Karpur. Tiffany Joy Keith. Keller. Jamie Jane Kilpatrick. Angela Jan Kazi. Anthony Francis Clare. Justin Michael Kleinsmith. Nathan Scott Cokemore. Kenneth Aaron Krutzinger. Troy Kyle.
Words from your class vice president, Javi Ramiro.
Hello, Mavericks. My task here today is to congratulate you seniors, and I gladly welcome the opportunity. Okay, maybe not gladly, but I'm nervous. As our final year comes to a close, we look back across the years we spent here at McNeil High. Memories enter our thoughts once again and for one last time. The good and bad times come together into this collection of feelings known as the past. The past is full of color from the kaleidoscope of success that we have all left behind. A victorious game, a successful opening night, a perfect dance, a beautifully published poem, a project that's earned a name, and coming out number one in stiff competition. But most of all, I congratulate us all for the friendships that we have made. These are our accomplishments, seniors. We live your accomplishments, bask in your glory, go forward to a successful future. But remember your past. Remember what you've learned. With persistence, you have achieved your goals at McNeil High. With that same persistence, your dreams of the future are not far. We are all unique Mavericks, and we will all gallop down the paths that have been less traveled, and that will make all the difference in the world. Congratulations, and good luck on the paths that you will now choose. And now, will the class of 1995 please join me in taking our first steps on our new paths by coming together for the last time in the symbolic gesture of moving our tassels from the left side to the right side of our graduation pass. For all you've done, seniors, enjoy the program. Our thanks to seniors Nathan Dekinga and Chris Wickham, and our faculty members, Ski Zablowski and Diane Ebert, for their hard work. Enjoy the show.
did it, people. You're wonderful. We'd like for you to stand now for the school alma mater. Arranged by Thomas Henson, class of 94. Lyrics by Amy Mitchell, class of 1994.